We were getting hammered every day. We were just getting shot at.
The stench of bodies.
There was a lot of exposure to a lot of powerful weapons at that time.
And you're seeing just these puffs of dirt everywhere.
We got hit with large ordnance.
A couple of them did lose their lives.
His weapon was caked with blood and dirt.
Anger, anguish.
The things that I, you know, saw, smelled, started thinking about, started to escalate.
If it's my time to die, it's gonna be my time to die. A lot of stuff stops mattering.
The sights and sounds and smells of those operations were absolutely contributed to where I am today. I spent a lot of effort trying to cover it so people don't realize what I'm doing. And that becomes very tiresome sometimes.
I knew I had adjustment issues when I first returned. I know I had anger issues. I knew I had all these symptoms, but I don't think that I really ever put a name to it.
I don't know how to not analyze every single person and judge if they're a threat to me or not. That's my PTSD. And it's just devastating because I can't relax to have even a Valentine's Day dinner with my wife.
Hey, Brendan.
Hey.
Just want to thank you so much for participating. We really appreciate what you're doing, taking time.
These soldiers are coming back with lots of things happening at the same time. So what we're doing is really trying to find out as much about all the things that happen at once in these soldiers, in these veterans, their psychiatric issues, their neurobiological issues, and even their physiological issues.
This is really the first time in American history where we've seen the conjoint of both mild traumatic brain injury and PTSD coming together at the same time in the same individual.
I think it's sometimes the first time where they've been able to describe all of their symptoms, both head injury and trauma, psychological trauma related, all in one place to the same person. And so I think it can be very empowering and validating for them to have someone hear the full story.
It's going to make you a better person. It's not something you're going to, you know, get well overnight, but the fact that you can manage it and have a normal life with your family and friends and to be able to function in society like anybody else.
The TRACTS program has been awesome. It has helped me look at situations that I'm dealing with from a different perspective. Instead of being a victim, I look at it as me being a survivor, and I know how to cope better.
Thank you so much.
And I just feel a lot happier.
We've been dealing with PTSD since Achilles, and this is some of the first research that's really going into PTSD and what it is scientifically.
From the beginning to the end of the day, when our participants get off the elevator, we greet them and we spend a few minutes to make them comfortable. We do blood pressure and a number of other medical procedures to kind of characterize their overall general health. From there, participants begin a very extensive neuropsychological battery to examine where their cognitive function is at. When that evaluation is done, we also have an emotional and psychiatric interview.
When they come here, they get a very comprehensive experience where I think they feel that their unique experience has been heard.
Their day actually winds up with neuroimaging scans, which look at the actual transmission of activity in the brain, and we can also measure whether there's any structural changes to either the cortex or the underlying white matter that are responsible for the transmissions of those functional networks.
It's an experience that you probably have never had before. It's a long day.
It's very nice to meet you.
But the day goes by in a snap because you move from one process to another. You deserve this opportunity to participate in this type of research.
It has made me want to stay with the VA. And it has gotten me to a VA counselor that I am working with now. So when I talk about hope, I think it's the better side of the VA for me.
Nothing can be changed from the past, but our future is still ahead. And every day is a struggle, but as long as you learn from all the tactics and experiences that you've been through, that your life can be much easier than it has been.
If they can just make that first step, that then they'll start meeting actual people, and then the people and the relationships will get things moving in the right direction.
They want to come in, they want to participate, because they're hoping for that cathartic feeling that they're whole again.
Now that I've found this program, I have great hope that this is going to work for me. At least I can speak, you know, about myself. I believe that I will get better. I believe that this is going to help me.
VA Research, improving veterans' lives.